welcome. Thank you so much for joining this session on system deployment best practices. My name is Sam Hammond, and I'm an engineering manager for the instructional design team in the Milestone Learning and Performance Department. Over the next 15 minutes or so, I'd like to share a bit of the work we've been doing to support partners deploying Milestone XProtect VMS systems using internal and community source best practices. Specifically, I'd like to introduce you to the Milestone Deployment Assistant. The Deployment Assistant is a free app developed by Learning and Performance that's full of best practice information, and it provides system integrators with a ton of great features to help deploy XProtect systems consistently, efficiently, and with increased customer satisfaction. During this session, I'll cover what the Deployment Assistant is, how it's designed to support you during XProtect VMS deployments, where to find and download it, and how to use it. And I'll be doing that last part by conducting a hands-on demo based on some specific use cases. So let's get right into it. First off, what is the Milestone Deployment Assistant and how is it related to best practices for deployment? In short, the Milestone Deployment Assistant is an app that provides a detailed interactive checklist you can follow when deploying XProtect VMS products. It's designed to improve your deployment processes, efficiency, and outcomes. The app covers the phases, tasks, and steps Milestone recommends following to ensure a successful XProtect VMS deployment, from preparing and installing the system all the way to extending and maintaining the solution. Plus, it's updated every software release so you can use it with the latest Milestone XProtect software. Now, you might be thinking, that sounds great, Sam, but where do the best practices come in? Good question, hypothetical audience member. In addition to the checklist order providing a recommended deployment workflow, the app also includes best practice recommendations every step of the way, including links to documentation, knowledge base articles, and other resources throughout the entire process. The best practices in the Deployment Assistant are developed by Milestone Learning and Performance in collaboration with our technical support, solution engineering, and R&D teams. So you know you're getting the best information possible. So to summarize, the Deployment Assistant's primary goals are to provide you with step-by-step guidance throughout XProtect VMS deployment and deliver best practice information right when you need it most. Again, sounds great, but some of you might be thinking, how does that benefit me and my business when I'm working with Milestone? Well, first off, we all know time is money, right? Every minute you're searching for the next bit of documentation or guidance that's relevant to the part of the deployment process you're at could be a minute you lose to your bottom line, your profitability. By providing you with a recommended workflow, plus access to best practices, plus links to the resources that are relevant to where you're at, the Deployment Assistant reduces research downtime and allows you and your team to be more efficient and effective. And since you're following a structured list of recommended steps, it also helps with consistency within and across projects and reduces the opportunity for tasks to get performed out of sequence or overlooked, which can be equally costly. The Deployment Assistant has even more features that support efficiency and consistency. It's built to the specific XProtect VMS product you're deploying, so you only see and interact with what you need. You can disable steps that aren't relevant to the specific project you're working on, or include your own custom notes so everyone's on the same page. Speaking of being on the same page, it also provides you with the ability to export and import project data, so you can share projects with your colleagues and support cross-collaboration. But one of my favorite Deployment Assistant benefits is increased customer satisfaction. The features and benefits we've already discussed ultimately lead to that. But the Deployment Assistant has one more perk on top of that. You can print off a completed project checklist as a PDF. This document can effectively form the basis for a final acceptance test that lists everything you performed on site. The app even allows you to print an optional customer sign-off page along with that PDF. It's designed to make that final handoff easy and satisfying for both you and your end customer. Now that we've gone over the purpose and benefits of the Deployment Assistant and how it supports best practices, I'd like to demonstrate how it works and how it supports specific use cases. But first, I want to mention a couple things. First off, you can download the Deployment Assistant for free at the URL you see on your screen, or you can use the QR code. The download is quick, easy, and again, completely free. You can also download the assistant's contents as a PDF guide if you choose. Second, I want to give a quick shout out to two great places to visit if you want to build Milestone expertise, our documentation portal and learning portal. Check out the documentation portal to search for and access thousands of topics related to XProtect VMS products in your preferred language, or download offline copies of manuals and guides. Or if you prefer more structured training, access the Milestone Learning Portal. There you'll be able to access free and customer e-learning courses, or enroll in our partner portal that features online training tracks, instructor-led online classes, and the opportunity to get certified to design and deploy Milestone solutions. All it takes to access our partner learning portal is a free My Milestone account that you can sign up for on the Milestone website in just a few minutes if you don't have one already. Okay, without further ado, let's get into a demo. So first things first, I've opened a browser and gone to the Deployment Assistant URL. I'm going to click on the Download Tool button to get the latest version of the app. And once that download completes, I'll run the installer with default settings. Okay, now that that's done, I'll select Finish and the app launches automatically. We're ready to get started. So let's say I'm an integrator that just got dispatched to deploy XProtect Professional Plus at a customer site, and I want to make sure this deployment is done according to Milestone best practices. In that case, I'll start by selecting New Deployment. I'll select Professional Plus, and then enter the name for my project. And I'll put down my integrator name, in this case, me, and I'll select Create Deployment. And there we go. The assistant automatically drops me into the deployment checklist for this project. You can see at the top here my project name and my name as the integrator. I can go back here to view all my projects and load a different one if I had one. But in this case, I'll just go back into the one we just created. On the side here, you'll see the deployment is divided into four phases: preparing and installing, configuring and organizing, defining and monitoring, and extending and maintaining. Each phase has its own list of numbered tasks, and each of those tasks has lettered steps. So let's say I've completed the first few steps here in task one, configure the network. To show I completed them, I'll just check it off, and you can see it's keeping track of my progress. The data saves automatically when I change something in a project, so you don't need to worry about saving. For step 1G, I need a bit of a refresher on Active Directory. In that case, I can select the step itself or the plus icon to expand out detailed information and best practices related to it. There's links to additional resources as well, so I can pull up the relevant article in the documentation portal to get what I need quickly and efficiently. I'll collapse this and move on. Okay, so as I'm moving along, completing steps, let's say I get to a step that isn't part of the scope of work for this deployment, and I want to indicate that it isn't relevant. For example, we're not using HTTPS communication on hardware for this customer. In that case, I can select the strike through icon on the right, and it will gray the step out and note that it doesn't apply. The last thing I'll show here is notes. So as I keep moving along, I get to step 3D about user accounts. Let's say I want to note the admin credentials I configured to access the VMS. In that case, I can select the note icon, it looks like a little speech bubble, and write down those credentials. And I'll save the note now, and it's recorded with my name and date. I can close that now, and you'll see the note icon is still lit up, and that notifies me there's some information there. And that's the basics for the checklist itself. It makes the deployment process straightforward and efficient, keeps track of your notes and actions, and provides resources and guidance right where and when you need it. Now I want to switch gears and show you a couple more things that the Deployment Assistant can do around collaboration and customer handoffs. First, let's look at sharing project data using the export and import functions. So let's pretend I've finished my day as an integrator, and I know I won't be coming back to the site tomorrow. I've got another job to finish up somewhere else, and a colleague of mine will be taking over instead. So I want to share what I've done so far with them so they can pick up where I left off. In that case, I can select Export Data over in the Actions menu here to save out a copy of the project. I can then share this encrypted project data file with my colleague over email or put on a thumb drive for them to have when they show up on site. Okay, now let's pretend I'm the new colleague showing up the next day. I've got my own laptop with the deployment assistant installed, and I want to load up the project data I was given yesterday. First, let me go back to the load deployment screen and delete out this project so we can pretend I'm coming in completely blank. Okay. Now I'll select Import Deployment on the side menu here and locate the project file my colleague gave me. Once I find it, it'll take a second to load in. Once it's ready, I'll select Import Deployment, and there we go. I get a confirmation saying the import was successful. When I go back to Load Deployment, you can see the project imported, and I can go into it and verify everything my colleague did yesterday is in there. Perfect. I want to change the integrator name for the steps I complete, though, and remove the import from the project title. So I'll just go over to Edit Details in the Actions pane and do that now. You can see I can also change the XProtect product here if that changes during deployment. The last thing I want to show you in this demo is the PDF printout. Let's say I've completed this project, and I want to share a log of what I completed with my end customer for final acceptance test and sign off. I'll click on Print View in the Actions pane, and you can see a status of all the steps I completed, when I completed them, notes, and so on. If I select Options on the side menu, I can load in a custom logo to replace the Milestone logo, and choose whether to include a customer sign-off page. Let's save my changes and then print to PDF. Once the conversion is done, it'll open the PDF in Acrobat or Acrobat Viewer. You'll need either one of those to be able to save to PDF. If I skip down to the bottom of the document, you can see the sign-off page. And that's pretty much it. If you have ideas for how to make the deployment assistant even better or want to report a bug or issue, please use the send feedback feature in the app or email us directly at deploymentfeedback@milestone.dk. We want to continue to deliver and improve on tools to help you deploy Milestone consistently, efficiently, and with satisfaction. One last time, you can start using the Deployment Assistant and enjoying its best practice tips and benefits today, absolutely free, by using the link on screen and downloading the latest version of the app. Thank you very much for attending this session on system deployment best practices. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you give the app a try. I'm looking forward to your feedback and wishing you happy deployments ahead. Take care.